Hello children, good morning. Today we discuss last concept, that is conservation of momentum. What is meant by momentum? First of all, momentum means it is nothing but p is equal to mass into velocity. Mass into velocity. If you take two balls, mass ma and mass mb, its initial velocity is ub. Here ab are two balls. Its mass ma, its mass mb, its initial velocity ua, its initial velocity ub. Okay, as you know very well, if u1 is greater than ub, definitely there is a chance of collision between these two balls. Okay, first ball collide the second ball, means a exerts some force on ball b. As you know very well, in the Newton's third law of motion, for every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. If one object applies some force on another object, in turn that second object also will give same amount of force in opposite direction. Yes, if both collide with each other, what will happen? If both the bodies collide with each other, means here force on A due to B and force on B due to A, both will be equal and opposite to each other during collision. Okay, so after collision, after collision also both the bodies could not be in the same in the contact only. After the collision, again the both bodies will be separated. Okay, their velocities also will be changed, va and vb. UA, UB are the initial velocities before collision. This is collision. Before collision, velocities UA, UB. After collision, VA and VB. Okay. So, according to Newton's third law, FAB is equal to minus FBA. Means, force on ball A due to B. Force on ball B due to A. This is the Newton's third law of motion. Okay, now what we have to do? By applying this rule, this Newton's third law, we have to equate both the forces. As you know very well, force is nothing but mass into acceleration. A means again final velocity minus initial velocity by time. Okay, now same thing we have to apply for these two different balls. Ma into VA minus UA. Because first body only I am telling here. Its final velocity VA, initial velocity UA by time is equal to mass of the ball B into final velocity minus initial velocity by time. Here minus will continue. Both side time we will get cancelled. Now, so multiply MA into VA, MA VA minus MA UA is equal to minus MB UB, minus MB UB, minus into minus plus MB UB, MB UB. Okay, now what we have to do? All the initial velocities one side and final velocity one more time we have to separate. Now see children, first body and its initial velocity, first second body and its initial velocity, means this is initial momentum of the first body, initial momentum of the second body. Means initial means before collision only, no? So this is total momentum before collision, total momentum before collision. Now it is equal to total momentum after collision. Total momentum after collision. Both are equal. This law is what we call conservation of momentum. Conservation means total momentum should be constant. That is the meaning. Conservation of momentum means the total momentum. So before collision, how that momentum will be? After collision also, the same momentum should be. Means for example, if you take one example of like a car and one truck. This is one truck, big truck. Both collide each other. One big truck. Both collide with each other. This one is MA. This one is MB. Velocities will be something will be. So, if both the bodies definitely have some momentum before accident or collision, okay. So, after collision also, they will have the same momentum. That's why then we will say the total momentum is constant. This is what we call conservation of momentum. Okay, Nana. So, in this way, only rocket working will be there, Nana. Rocket launching. Okay, in the rocket propulsion also, conservation of momentum will be valid. That's why the rocket principle is conservation of momentum only. The law is third law, but the principle is conservation of momentum, because rocket will exert some gases, means some momentum will be changed. So the rocket will be go fly off, then also some momentum will be changed. In that case, total momentum will be equal. So, that rocket principle is conservation of momentum. That law is Newton's third law of motion. Children, so with this concept, our lesson is finished. You have to practice those question and answers. And before that, you have to read that lesson, each and every point.